Welcome to Daytona for our 20th race of the season. We've reached a halfway point and 20 more races to go. Remy and Fisher in the 5 starts on the pole with the 7 right next to him. Now we're going to take a look at the 10 because he knows how to get it done here at Daytona and Talladega, but mostly Daytona. He won the 500 in a crazy finish. Hoping to do it again. He's going to try to be the first. Oh, trouble with the 16 already. That ain't good. Another driver who isn't doing very well. Anyways, talk about the number 10 again. So the 10 is the second driver to sweep first at Daytona. But he's going to try to be the first driver to sweep twice in the ISCR. And sweep twice at Daytona as well. That would be crazy. No one has ever done that except him. But that was in a different series, though. So, yeah. Buddy's still in the books. A history book, I guess. The ISCR history book. So, pace car is already in. Here we go. We're getting ready for the green. Green flag is out. Here we go. Whoa! I think some drivers already made some contact. Out of 10 in the 500, he started last and won the race. Now, this time he doesn't start last, but he still starts on the rear. But, can he do it again? That's the question. Can he sweep Daytona twice? Become the first driver to do it at Daytona in the Cup Series. So the 48 leaves his teammate, does not follow him. Fisher wants to go on the outside. 19 of Joseph Curtis, right there in third. He's moving in, got the two behind. Riley Houston Jr. won to the Talladega race. He's gonna try, oh, trouble, 32 hard in the wall, lots of cars spinning. And a wreck, right on the first lap, whoa. Gonna take out a couple of the drivers here. Caution's out on the first lap. 48, Riley Houston Jr. is the leader. Pace car is out. We'll take a look what happened. Alright, here's the replay. Malik Nevis in the 4 car. He lost it. He was there. And he got into the wall pretty hard. Then got into the 09 and then into the 32. Back in front of traffic. Takes out a couple more cars. Look at the 10! What a wreck of one. And a double zero. 13 was close, but yeah. And when it comes to Daytona, Aureus really knows how to avoid it. And then he avoids another one, too. Somewhat. And we got another spinner. That's the 42, Mitchell Riggs. And, oh man, that 21 was so close. That was a close call. Good avoidance right there, yeah. Then Jay Stella starts to smoke. Things blowing up as well as the 36. 32, looks like he's already out. Still having that bad season. Bradley Bishop Jr., also, another driver who knows how to get it done here at Daytona, is involved in this first caution, first wreck. Either way, we'll take you back. Alright, we're getting ready. The 16, no sight. The 16 car, so she ain't gonna receive any points. So that's a heartbreaker there. So Riley Houston Jr. up in front. Joseph Curtis in second in the number 19. In second, hoping that he can win tonight. Henry Powers in the 2 in third. Fourth, Megan Smith in fifth. Ramian Fisher. And we're back underway. Here we go. Joseph pushing the 48 to 2. Bad start. He jumps to the outside. So does the 14 and the 24. The 5 on the bottom. Here comes the 19. Now he's going to try to take the lead away. Here comes the 2, he has a 5 right behind. Two to the inside, Henry Powers. Got the 5 behind as well, Samuel Bashan, the 01. Looks like we're going to go 3 wide. 3 wide, here we go. 3 wide. Okay, that's enough, 48. Out there, his teammates won't help. Okay, that can't be good. Whoa, close call right there. Houston scraped the wall, that's okay. Here comes Samuel Bash in the 01. Side by side for the lead. Here we go. Hayden in the 7. Intro! 24's on the wall. Bouncing all over the place. Nearly caused another wreck. DJ Curtis is on the apron. Trying to get back onto the track. And he's alright. Austin Wong Gold in the 87. Yep. One of the drivers who are suffering one of the halfway point curse. I don't know why I call it that, but whatever. Won two races early in the season, and everything started to go down fast when we were starting to close in on the heading into the other half of the season. Man, look at that 24 and the 48. No one helped him. 24 also bounced off the wall. That caused him to slide all the way back. The 48 got held back by his own teammate. So he's all the way back there, bouncing off the wall again. I don't know how to fix it, and no one wants to make another Daytona. That sucks. I want a new Daytona, damn it. Connor Reaton, the 51, up to the front. You got the 8 of Tristan Parker behind, and with the 12 and the 20 on the bottom. Daytona favored by a lot of drivers. Because if it's, you have a better chance of winning here, because, yeah. But most of the, well, almost all the time, the big one always strikes early. We had a small one, though. Bouncing off the wall again. Whoa. We're bouncing off way too hard. There's no way to fix that without having to edit the LP line. But I can't do that because Sandbox does not want me to fix it. Keep giving me these 3DO errors. No, Joseph Curtis is in the wall! Who's gonna get collected? And it's gonna be the 22, Jesse Turner hard! Mason Powers and Jesse Turner. Oh man. He almost flipped Joseph. Another good run until. He had a good run going on. That's what I was meant to say. And now he's destroyed. The Penske drivers pushing each other. Looks like the 12 is gonna lead this one, or the 2 is gonna try to get him himself. Nah. No. No reason to do it, but he's just gonna open the door for no reason. Here we go. So caution is out. Brandon Nicholas in the 12 is the leader. We'll take a look at what happened. Take a look at what happened. Fuck. So pissed. Damn Talladega race. That driver. Okay, that car. Somewhat. God damn it. We'll take a look at the replay now. See, Joseph Curtis. These drivers not giving each other room. 4 wide, 7 bounced off the wall, no room. Gone to Joseph, kept leaning and leaning. Joseph tried to retaliate, Hayden retaliated back. Then he kept on hitting him. Kept on going, then spun him around. And there's the yellow. Lots of drivers avoided it, but two unlucky drivers couldn't. First the 22 hard on the driver's side, and then the 88 Mason Powers slammed into the 22 really hard. Surprised that thing is not smoking. Well, he's out anyways. I'm pretty sure he will be out because I don't think the officials will allow him to get back out there without having to fix a few things. And yeah, don't think they'll fix it. They're fixable. So there's your second caution of the day. Humongous wreck, taking out 3 drivers. We'll take you back. Okay, not humongous, but you know what I mean. Humongous hit. There we go. Alright, we're getting ready for the restart. 30 drivers left. The 83 and 38 for some reason are out. Don't know why though. I think they wrecked and I didn't see it. So the 88, 22, 19 of course out. 30 drivers left on the track. Pace car is heading in. We're almost closing in. God damn, what's wrong with me? We're closing in on the halfway point. Here we go. Green flag. So the top 4 drivers stay single file while everyone else is trying to get some positions. Ah. Yep. Well, thanks to Talladega. Colin Breton now right behind the 8. Here comes the 11. Oh, here comes the 2 now. He's trying to block. The 12 does not go down. He wanted him to go down. Now he goes to the middle. I think they're trying to step things up. Let the 12 drop back. Push the 2. Yeah, he's gonna do that. He's staying on the high side though. 3's coming up fast. The 11 and Kyle Collins to the front. There goes the 8 with the 51 behind. 41 and 1 and 21 all on the bottom. Whoa, Patrick Mew getting awfully close. He goes back to the high side, barely any room. And he goes back to the middle. 12 trying to get up high with the 2. The 2 does not want to come down. He goes to the bottom now. The 51, Connor Breeden to the lead. Dixon Houston in the 41, right behind. The 1 of DJ Curtis to the bottom. 21 does not follow. The 12 goes to the bottom. The 5 also there with the 43 and 48. 48 has worked his way back up. He's back in this. He packed in. There's the 24 who is trailing. Something really went wrong with that car, having to bounce off the wall pretty hard. More cars bouncing off. The 9 of Fitzwater to the bottom on the apron. He can make the pass there, but once he enters turn 1 and 2, it's going to be tough. Really tough, and he gets back onto the track. No problem. Now the 47 goes to the apron. I don't want to do that in the corner. He's going to lose a lot of spots, a lot of ground. See, that's what just happened right there. The 01, 8 to the high side. Trying to make something happen here. 47 gets back up to speed. Back to the 190. And above. Or above, yeah. 12 of Brendan Nicholas working his way back up to the front. He's now in second. Just notice we were already on the halfway. Yeah, we passed the halfway point. This is the halfway point. Okay, doesn't matter now. Pack is separate because of that wall. And here comes a 12 to the bottom with the 43 right behind. Connor Smith had a lot of big hits at Sonoma, but he's doing very well tonight, trying to get a win. 48, Riley Houston Jr. behind, trying to put his Talladega skills to work. Same setup. Oh, the 01 of Samuel Bash almost got turned by Trey Phelps. I saw that car in the apron. Both of them went down, and the 00 is just following that 01. Keeps going wherever he's going. Yeah. Keeps going wherever he wants. Yeah, he's just following him. He's just stalking him right now. They're working with each other now. They're catching up on the 5 of Fisher, who is yet to win. But remember about the halfway point curse. Some drivers ain't cursed. 12 bounced off the wall. His teammate right behind, but he goes to the middle. Now he's gonna ditch him. 21 Lawrence to the front. DJ Curtis in the 1. Trying to break the bad luck streak for the Curtis family. Trying to do it. Fitzwater in the 9. Right behind. 41 and 5. 01003. As well as behind all the way on the bottom line. Where is the 10? The 10 is somewhere. There he is. Getting past the 18 now. He is in this lead pack. His teammate is being separate by the 18. The 7 has dropped back heavily. The 17 of Noodles now pushing his former teammate up there. See, Marlene, the 18, almost won Sonoma. And the 500 did poorly because of the early wreck and the duels. But doing very well tonight, well, somewhat. Ziki Marlene needs some help. Gotta push. Well, he's gotta find someone. He wants another caution, the 10, right behind the 20. Look at this big pack of drivers. Someone is going to wreck again. And we don't even know who, but someone in the middle, of course. There we go. There goes Trey Phelps. Oh, there we go. Connor Smith sliding through, and it looks like this is the big one. No, it's not. Never mind. Out of 51. Oh, man, the 3. He missed 2, but couldn't miss 3. Caution. Caution with 11 laps to go. Leader is the 5. We'll take a look at what happened. I knew that was going to happen. See how the 9 getting pushed by the 43 on the left side. First a 00, 43 recovering. Squeezed the 1 into the wall pretty hard, but doesn't spin. 51, 2, 92 got a piece, 47. I think the 10 got into the 8, or the 8 got into the 10. Can't tell. Smoke all over the place. 51 going for a slide in the grass. Locked up the brakes, which is a good thing, but then got hit by the 3. Where's the 43? He did a nice save, I believe. And where did the 43 go? I thought it was heading down pit road, but decides not to. Oh, there he is. Wow, that was crazy what he did right there. He causes the wreck. Yeah. He went sideways, but then came back, almost spun him. And look at that, that's ridiculous. How do you do that? He crossed the line, but I guess you're not going to penalize him, maybe? I don't know. We'll just have to wait and see. We thought that was going to be the big one, but surprisingly, only a couple of drivers were involved. We'll take you back. Getting ready for the green. The 5 is up in front. The 14 had a camshaft problem. Oh, boy. Lots of drivers have been having a lot of mechanical issues. 28 drivers left. Still got a big pack of cars. Still, the big one is not strike yet. Oh, man. Green flag. Fisher in front. Dixon Houston right behind. Samuel Bash and Zachary Fitzwater, his teammate, and 15 Riley Houston, who won Sonoma. So Connor Smith, of course, really slow after that. Did a nice save, but has a lot of damage on his car, holding back a lot of drivers. 24 making some moves. Maybe not. Yeah, kind of. I don't know. Maybe. Someone's going to dump the 43. Could be the one. Could be anyone, actually. Almost anyone. And damn it. We'll just have to take a look. 02. Yep. It's going to get some free spots. Hoping that 43 just stays back so he doesn't allow fast drivers to get right by. And that 43 is being penalized right now. Someone's going to dump someone. Drivers are getting impatient, of course. So they're always impatient. Here comes DJ. 7 up to the top. Didn't work. 6 laps to go. We're going to get a caution. Better get one now. 13 into the wall. Everyone on the bottom. 2 drivers being held back. Back to the front. Well, that sucks. Samuel Bash to the front. Thanks to that number 43. Just held everyone back. Yep. 20 goes to the inside. Does not help his teammate. Wow. It's Daytona. Sometimes you just can't trust your teammates. A 10 to the top, though. Trying to go to the bottom. Doing very well. Avoided a lot of wrecks. He is in this. And he has a teammate in front. That's the number 92. Here comes a 5 to the inside of the 9. Side by side for the lead. Dixon and Samuel. Side by side for third as well. 92 and 10. 15 to the bottom. Squeezes right through. Perfect. Very slow drivers. Going equal speeds, looks like. Everyone's pretty much clear. All these drivers who had a chance to win this race just got screwed over right there. The 5 of Fisher. Oh, Houston got into him. Oh, careful getting back up on the track. Well, they just put those 2 drivers out. The 5 is not going to be happy for sure. He's going to dump that 15 at the end of the race, maybe. Or now. So here comes Patrick Mew in a 20. Have not won a race so far with his new team. Pushing the 01, Samuel Bash. Dixon Houston in command. 3-car battle for the lead. The 9 and 10. Let's see if they can make something happen. Here comes the 20. There goes the 10. He does not want to help. He just wants to get up in front. 18. He might just push the 10. Dixon still leading. Samuel to third. We're coming to 3 to go as well. 3 wide over here. Look at how many spots Houston and Fisher lost on that. So Dixon Houston leading still. Patrick Mew in second. I don't think he's ever won a Daytona before. There's a 10. Aureus in fourth. He is catching the 01. He's trying to, trying to sweep twice. No one's ever swept twice. And Aureus is trying to be the first driver to do it. And he's there. He is there. He really has a fast car. Same setup as from the 500. He really knows how to get around these super speedways. He has 3 Daytona wins. Looking for his 4th here today at the Coke 400. Coke Zero 400. Don't matter. He tries the outside. 2 laps to go. Samuel is to the inside trying to get past Patrick Mew. 4 car battle. Make it 5 maybe if the 23 can catch. But this drag race going on. Oh, here he comes. Make it 5. See, that drag race really, really affects a lot of these drivers. Here comes Aureus to the inside. Started at the back again, but not last this time. God damn it, what the fuck? Coming to the white. Five-car battle. Patrick New falls to fifth. Still got a chance. Dixon Houston has a small gap on Aureus. The 23, the rookie, pushing the 10. Everyone's trying to race, and there's slow cars up ahead. Only going 160. White flag. One more lap to go. This is going to be bad. Lap traffic is going to screw this finish up. I know it is. Dixon Houston in command. Aureus got hung out to dry. Here comes the 23, the rookie, in the Coca-Cola car. Got the 20 of Patrick Mule looking. He's looking. The 23 to the outside. Which line will be the preferred line? Because every line is blocked except for the middle. You never know what's going to happen. Here it comes. Oh my god. Who's going to win this thing? This is bad. 23 to the bottom. The 1. They're going to try to get past the 1. They do it. They did it. Oh boy. Really slow, these drivers. Dixon on top. Oh, he's getting a push from the 10. Dixon Houston. Big push. He's going to win at Daytona. Wow. That was pretty crazy. Nothing to scream over about, though, which is sad. But Aureus just helped Dixon Houston win this race. He finished the second. Almost wrote history. Or make history. Either one. Curtis so close. Third for him. Patrick fourth. Fifth Samuel Bash. So Dixon Houston wins, Aureus second, third Curtis Dilger, fourth Patrick Mew, fifth Samuel Bash, sixth Zeke Marley, seventh Zachary Fitzwater, eighth Brandon Nicholas, ninth Chris Kyle, and tenth Noodles Noodley. Here's the rest of the race results. 28 drivers finished today's race. One driver did not start the race in the 01, pushing the 20. Looks like he ain't happy with him. Anyways, let's now take it to victory lane. Good job by the 41 team.